Ghana Medical Association has threatened to strike if government and the Ministry of Health does not take measures to pay to meet their demands. Earlier, the association served notice its members will embark on strike if government fails to immediately implement signed conditions of service. It will be recalled that in July 2015, the Ghana Medical Association embarked on a three-week strike over the lack of codified conditions of service. The association was then demanding a signed document detailing the entitlements of members as part of their conditions of service. That strike was called off after several appeals from Ghanaians. In 2018 also, the Ghana Medical Association called off a planned strike after government agreed to address these same issues. Again, in 2019, the Ghana Medical Association threatened to withdraw services over government's failure to implement agreed conditions of service for its members. Let's quickly get onto the telephone lines and speak with the General Secretary of the Ghana Medical Association, Dr. Titus Bayo, who joins us now. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much. We're grateful for your time. So what has the Ministry of Health been telling you? Because this, I'm told, is not the first time that this issue has come up.
Okay, good afternoon, and thank you for having me, and thank you for the opportunity. But let me make a little correction. I'm the Deputy General Secretary and not the General Secretary.
Thanks for the clarification.
Okay. Yeah. So, well, I would say that since our statement, there have been some engagements, and we do have some schedule of meetings this afternoon. So by close of day, we should be able to give you updated status of whatever it is. But it's unfortunate that it always has to come to this level, you know, because what it is that we have had discussions, we negotiated these conditions of service, all sides were there, we all made concessions, we made some agreements, we signed it somewhere last year and supposed to take effect from this year. And then, again, we hit a snag with implementation. We've had a month, January salaries paid, and nothing reflected. We are in February, and it doesn't look like things are going to be different. And so that is how come we've had to get to this point again.
Right.
But since we are engaging, I would say let's hold ourselves a bit, and maybe by close of this evening we would be able to.
So this assurance or this expression of hope you're making to who? Your association members? You're calling on them to be patient a little bit and wait to see how things go, or what?
Yes, we are telling our members, because what is happening is our rank and file members across the country are very agitated and do not understand what is happening.
Right.
You know, because we had a conditions of service document that expired for a whole year. It took an entire year working with an outmoded, an expired document. And our document is signed every 3 years. And a new one should have been implemented in 2019. But the entire 2019, we worked with an old one of 4 years old of age, let me put it that way. So people's patience, it's at their limit. You know, but we just want to appeal for calm among our members, that since the members directed us and we gave out that decision in writing, we have had some overtures from government and we are engaging. And so we also want to just tell the generality of the Ghanaian public, more especially our clients who we serve in the various hospitals, that we do have engagement with government, ongoing engagement, and we hope that before our deadline that we have given, we may be able to come up with something positive.
Make some good progress. But now, let's go back to November last year. I know that the Ghana Medical Association rescinded a threat to strike and a circular to its members. President of the association, Dr. Frank Ankobia, said that government has agreed to address these issues. You have just raised it. I want to know, what has changed or what has not changed?
Well, so what has changed is that at that point, we were negotiating a document which I told you had expired by a year. And we had taken a whole, longer than usual time to agree on this document. And so when we came to a consensus and all parties signed the document, we exercised good faith and said, once they have signed the document as the new conditions of service document that we are going to work with, then there was no need to carry out the decision that our members had taken. So we looked at good faith that has been executed by government, which was that they signed the document off, and we all agreed on the table that was supposed to be implemented from the 1st of January, because government said they were going to put it in their budget. And so even though it was completed in November, implementation was not going to be until January. So that was what made us take that decision then. What has changed is that January has passed, February is almost done, we have received validation of salaries and all of that, and we do not see any reflection of the new document, and this is what has changed.
Right, and we know also that government agreed in 2019 they're about to unfreeze market premiums with the effect from May 2013. I want to know how far this has gone. Are you, has this agreement been effected?
So I won't want to go into the details, but all I can say is that the new conditions of service, none of it has been implemented at all in this year 2020. Right. We are still working with a condition of service that was signed in 2015, 2016, which expired in 2018,
right,
which we should have renewed in 2019. And we took all of the year after several warnings for government to come to the table.
Right.
Eventually, we came to an agreement in 2019 in November, and that's why it made us rescind our decision then,
right,
hoping that we're going to have implementation in January. So you can understand how our members feel when in January we are still getting salaries and everything, which are values that were agreed in 2015, 2016. So that is what the situation is.
Right, Doc.
Yeah.
Doc, thank you very much for your time. Dr. Titus Bayo is the Deputy General Secretary of the Ghana Medical Association.